I want to share a story with you today about a change process that I underwent when I was a manager at a large government organisation in Melbourne. The department I worked for was about to merge with another department, and that meant that some of the staff were going to either be reallocated work roles or they would have to move positions in the office. And it reminds me of one of my staff, Vivian, who had been employed in the agency for some 15 years. When the change process was announced, I noticed that Vivian became visibly shaken and very nervous at what the future held. And I remember talking to her and asking her what her concerns were. And she said to me that change had happened in the department before, it hadn't been well managed, and that she felt that because of the change, she would have to move desks. It was a big issue for Vivian, but it wasn't a big issue for me until I thought about it. Vivian's desk looked like the bedroom of a 16-year-old. There was teddy bears over there, flowers, souvenirs from holidays, and tins of biscuits. To move her from a desk would nearly require the services of a removalist. So I said to her that I would try and keep her in the same desk as much as possible, but as for work roles, any work roles, she would be reskilled. So I set about trying to create a platform where I actually instilled trust into Vivian. So Vivian trusted me to manage her concerns. Now, most people think trust is a word about somebody believing in you or doing the right thing by you, but actually trust has five elements. In trust, there's integrity, openness, competence, consistency, and empathy. And I want to focus on the word consistency today. In a change process, there needs to be a consistent message, that the same message gets given to all the staff, that it's actually not diluted in any way, that they all understand the reasons for the change and it allays any fears. I had a number of meetings with Vivian, and every time we had the meeting, which was every second day, I made sure that I continued to build the trust element in Vivian that I could manage the change and lower her resistance to the change by giving her consistent messages. At the end of the change, she was very happy. We only had to move it 20 metres. We didn't have to get the removalists in, and we all lived happily ever after. So the moral to the story is, if you're a manager, build those elements of trust in your staff, of integrity in yourself, consistency, the competence and empathy to try and understand the other issues facing people about to undergo a change process.